We begin tonight with the latest in Iran and the Ayatollah's threat of a crackdown on protesters. Republican U.S. Congressman Mike Pence of Indiana, introduced a bipartisan resolution today that condemns the Iranian government's violence against the demonstrators and affirms the importance of democratic and fair elections. Mr. Pence, thank you for joining us tonight. What are you trying to change in our national policy with this resolution?
Well, we just thought that it was important for the American people, through their elected representatives, to have a chance to be heard on the world stage. And I partnered with the Democrat chairman of the Foreign Affairs Committee, Howard Berman. We put together a bipartisan resolution, Chris, that got 405 votes today that expresses the support of the American people for the Iranian citizens who are standing up for freedom and democracy and basic human rights. We also took the opportunity to condemn the violence by the government of Iran against dissenters and to denounce the repression of communications in a free and independent press in that country. I thought it was a very good moment for the House of Representatives. I'm informed within the hour here that the United States Senate took up a similar resolution and passed it. So the American people have sent a clear and unambiguous statement of support to those extraordinarily brave men and women who have taken to the streets on behalf of their right to self-government and fundamental human rights. And I'm humbled to have been a part of it.
What do you make of Mousavi, the guy who's leading the opposition? What do you make? Is any better than Ahmadinejad?
Well, I think that's a very interesting debate. I know the president indicated that there wasn't much difference. I've seen some accounts that suggest that he does, reflect more of a reformist attitude. But, you know, today's resolution really wasn't about endorsing an opposition candidate. It was about endorsing the people who have taken to the streets in Iran on behalf of their right to free and fair elections. And now that the Congress has spoken, I was pleased to hear the president, through his spokesman today, welcomed our resolution. I think that, as David Ignatius wrote in the Washington Post this morning, I think the time has come as well for the president to speak an unambiguous word of support for those Iranian citizens, and I'm hoping he'll do that.
What do you think the Iranian people, the mass of them, were watching over there on both sides of this fight? The ones who like the election results, who are apparently the majority, who knows, and the minority we're seeing out in the street, which is very vocal, obviously, and very impressive, I must say. I'm rooting for those people myself as a citizen. What do you think they think of America?
Well, I can't say.
I mean, you. What do you think of you and the other people in Congress who voted today? What do you think their reaction will be when they read this on the wires or see it on television? What do you think they'll think of an American resolution coming out of Congress like the one you passed today?
Well, my hope is, and I've actually received phone calls in my office from people within Iran who've expressed their appreciation for our efforts to express the support of the American people for the courage of those men and women taking to the streets. There are obviously profound differences between the interests of our two nations at this time, differences between our forms of government. But I must tell you, I thought this was a moment, and still is a moment, where the people of the United States could speak a word of encouragement to what is hundreds of thousands, or Chris, maybe millions, of men and women who essentially are standing up for their right to self-government, to freedom, to free expression, and I hope it's received as just that.
Well, I just talked to Joe Klein of Time Magazine. Of course, he's a serious reporter who just got back from hanging around the streets over there the last week, and he said those people over there, even the ones we think are on our side, what we call the reformers, and I agree with you completely. I'm with them all the way. I love the fact they're fighting for democracy. Who wouldn't?
Right.
We're Americans.
Right.
We believe in it.
Right.
But I'm worried about our track record over there and what they really think of our motives, because we backed that coup over there back in 53. We knocked off their incipient democracy and put a monarchy on the throne over there, a pro-Western oil potentate, the Shah, who was useful to us, maybe useful to Israel, but he certainly wasn't useful to that country. We backed Iraq against Iran in that bloody war that apparently, according to Joe, there's a guy he bumped into over there, a reformer, who said we're responsible for giving them the chemical weapons that Saddam Hussein used against the Iranians in that terrible war back in the 80s. What do we have to do to reestablish that we're not in there to screw around with them, to interfere with their elections, that we want them to be a free people? How do we do that?
Well, I think maybe it began a little bit today in the House and the Senate, where the people of the United States of America, through their Congress, essentially gave a cheer of encouragement and support to the people that are taking a stand for their own right to self-government. We also, again, I mentioned we condemn the violence, we condemn the repression of a free and independent press. You know, I know the president has drawn the line at, and I think it's been admirable that the president has said that he was troubled about the violence. He said that the people had a right to be heard and respected. But I respectfully disagree with the president drawing the line at not meddling and not going further. I just think Congress was right today to say that this was an opportunity for our people in this country, and I hope ultimately our president, to speak a word of encouragement for people who are obviously, Chris, fighting for fundamental human rights and freedom and self-government. And I think that could be a new beginning.
Okay, let's switch the topic to us. American interests, pure and simple.
Yeah.
Our interests. Forget there's even people over there that are human beings. Just our interest in this country. We don't want them to get a nuclear weapon because we don't like the looks of their government. There are countries in the world that have nuclear weapons we can live with. Certainly France, and we can live with Israel as long as there's not a war over there, of course. They don't use it, of course. We don't want them ever to use it. Certainly the Indians are pretty trustworthy over the years. The Pakistanis. We do worry about all those countries generally having weapons, but we don't have a particular worry about them. We would have a huge worry if Ahmadinejad had a finger on the button. What do you think your resolution did to keep his finger away from such a button? Did it have any positive advantage in that regard?
Well, no, you know, that's more of I support the strongest possible sanctions against Iran. We've supported bipartisan efforts to restrain their nuclear ambitions. I'll continue to do that. You know, today was really about saying that that 1 week on, where people have risked their liberty and their lives, that the American people would not be silent. I mean, what I see happening on the streets there, I think you see it happening. I think freedom appears to have gotten, the genie has gotten out of the bottle, if you will. And the cause of America, Chris, is freedom. And on that cause, we must never be silent, whatever the short-term diplomatic calculation is.
Well, my concern, I think, is the president's concern on a much higher level than me. And that is, we start looking like we're interfering in their politics by taking an official position on this election. We get Ahmadinejad and the Ayatollah Khamenei, those guys at the top, and they start saying, now we have a real justification for building a weapon, because this country's coming in trying to influence us again, like it did back in 53, like it did back in the 80s, like it did when we took it and protected the Shah against their democracy last time. Couldn't they make a case on the inside? The more we screw around with them, the more we tell them what to do through sanctions or whatever we do, that they've got to fight, and the best way they could do it is have a nuclear bomb. Don't we encourage them to circle the wagons by the way we act if we get too aggressive?
Well, I understand that concern, but I don't think condemning violence against innocent civilians or condemning a repression of the free press or supporting men and women who are standing up for fundamental human rights is ever against America's interests, whatever the outcome would be, whether it strengthens their hand or not. To be honest with you, I wasn't surprised when you saw Ahmadinejad this week say that after a week where the president had taken a very cautious, a very restrained approach, Ahmadinejad said that President Obama was meddling in their affairs. You know, the tyrants in Tehran are going to say whatever they're going to say. This opportunity today in Congress, and I hope the president takes an opportunity in the days ahead, was an opportunity, seems to me, to speak to the people of Iran and let them know, just like Ronald Reagan did. You know, I was at that Reagan dedication, that statue dedication, last time we saw one another. And, you know, when he went and stood in front of the Brandenburg Gate, Chris, he didn't say, "Mr. Gorbachev, that wall is none of our business." Ronald Reagan said, "Mr. Gorbachev, tear down that wall." He spoke truth to power, even all the while that he engaged the Soviet Union in a way that ultimately resulted in the collapse of that flawed, tyrannical communist system.
The trouble is, we don't have a clean track record in Iran. We fought for democracy. And by the way, in my religion, we prayed for the conversion of Russia every Sunday through the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s. We were all for democracy in that country. Our track record in Iran is not clean. We did not support democracy back then when we overthrew their democracy back in the 50s, when we encouraged Iraq to go to war with them, when we supported the Shah against the people in the streets. Our record all these decades, for six decades now, has been against democracy over there. I hope the hell now we're for democracy. Democracy in Iran. I agree with you, by the way. It's a legitimate debate we're having here. I completely respect what you did today, but I think we got to be careful to be honest brokers. When we push for democracy in that part of the world, especially in a country that's getting ever more sophisticated and more modern all the time like Iran, we better well have honesty on our own side. Anyway, thank you. Congratulations on your victory today. Congressman Mike Pence, a member of the House Republican leadership who won through that bipartisan measure today overwhelmingly.